can do.
Guys, before the show starts, can I get a picture with
you? Yes. Absolutely. Yes. Yes. Yes.
Oh, no, no. Oh.
I'm a little fucked up. I've already fucked up. Hello! Welcome! Good afternoon, everyone! How are we enjoying Hall Match? Welcome to the Holiday Matsuri 2022 Winter Cosplay Championship.
We are so excited to be here.
Just me and my husband.
My beautiful wife. Mm-hmm. All right. Wait a second.
Yeah, wait a second.
Daughter. Our beautiful, beautiful daughter. Come on.
Come on,
we miss you.
Son.
Oh. There you are. Thank you, daughter. All right.
I am learning a lot about myself today.
Yes. None of it good. None of it good.
No.
We are so excited to be here for the Winter Cosplay Craftsmanship. We have an incredible show lined up for all of you, even those who were naughty. All right? This event is completely flush with amazing cosplay costumes and some phenomenal performances.
Yes, we will be your MCs tonight. We're incredibly excited to be up here with you guys. As you can see, we've been visited by the ghost of cosplay present, and we're gonna bring you this amazing spy family group. Totally amazing.
Thank you. The one person who started cheering was like, this deserves some pity for those two.
Yeah.
Like, I'll grant you that.
Yeah. My name is Zach. Most people know me as Stripper Vash. There it is. Take it in. And as you can tell by my voice in my immaculate costume here, I am and have always been my papa's daughter. I'm Anya Forger.
And going right back to foster care.
Yeah.
All right, and I am Jim. Many people know me as Volt. I thought a bit ahead with my name.
Yeah.
All right, and today I am cosplaying just a totally normal psychiatrist from Berlin General Hospital, and absolutely positively not a spy.
Only a Sith deals in absolutes.
All right, maybe so.
And I'm Yaya Han, and today I'm just cosplaying, you know, your average clerk working at City Hall and not the greatest assassin in the world.
And the best wife.
Are we not going to talk about like the incredibly disparate difference in our costumes here? Like, you both look incredible and I have this is like a screen print. You know what? No, I can't even
precious.
Call this. I can't even call this a towel. Like, I need a towel. Like, after a shower, I want a towel. Dobby would not have accepted this for
it's
his
true.
Freedom.
It's
You're
true.
You're precious. And is he not perfect the way Anya-chan, right?
Oh, no.
Oh,
the audience
the
is a liar.
Is.
That's wonderful. Well, you're up for adoption. There seems to be
hey.
A couple.
Oh, hey.
Oh, so sorry. Hmm?
What did you say? Excuse me?
Something, not adoption. You're not a, you're, no. You're staying.
Yeah.
You're going. All right.
Mama and Papa are flirting.
All right. Now, you might be wondering how we were able to make these excellent cosplays. All right? We haven't seen Spy Family, all right, at all.
Yeah. I'm going to inflict a lot of violence on them later on, but
there we go.
We figured that we could just glean everything from the cosplayers here.
Oh.
And just kind of figure the whole show out.
What are some of your ponderings? What do you think?
Well, I didn't see a single Anya that didn't have a beard this weekend, so I figured we were like dead on the money with
yeah.
this. So
Nailed it. All right.
Shall we get moving into the
I
next segment?
I think we should.
That's right.
Get ready.
All right, guys. Let's get the show started. Sorry, I'm just very distracted trying to take care of these two, you know? They're a handful. Anyway, we are here to celebrate cosplay. So,
woo!
The Winter Cosplay Championship is a qualifying event for three international cosplay competitions. First off, the GCOF USA, a Paris competition that will take our winners to GCOF in South Korea. Very exciting.
Ooh. Next, we have the Holiday Matsuri International Cultural Exchange. This is a prize package for two, sending Hall & Mack cosplayers to different international events with the hope of sharing cosplay around the world. Our 2022 cultural exchange partner is the World Cosplay Summit in Nagoya, Japan. Yeah, that is worth clapping for.
Yep.
And finally, we have the Nordic Cosplay Championship, where a solo competitor will become the first U.S. representative to compete in the NCC finals at Närcon Sommar in Linköping, Sweden. Mm-hmm. And this is our first time participating in the Nordic Cosplay Championship, and their amazing organizer, Sam, has sent us a trailer for the 2023 season. So let's take a look.
Once in person at Närcon, and I was like crying. It was incredible. Anyway, in addition to these international event packages, we are thrilled to announce prizing from our sponsors. So let's hear it for Famori Cutlery, Janome, Arta Wigs, Surebonder, Hoku Props, and Sew Tights. All of our sponsors, yeah,
yeah,
give it up for them, yeah. They are so invested in this event. They are gonna be providing custom prizing packages.
That's right. Famori will be providing certificates, custom engraved shears for our winners, and providing a special Famori Joy of Cosplay Award.
Arta Wigs will be providing certificates and a hand-picked wig styling package in addition to certificates for all winners, runners-up, and judges' awards.
That is so generous.
Yes, it is.
Very nice. Surebonder will be providing prizing for our winners and an award for best armor that includes tools for your next creative creation.
Sew Tights has sent some phenomenal magnet systems that can be used both for the sewing craft and for wearing cosplays. These magnet systems will be included in the prizing for our winners and our runners-up.
As a recent addition to our prizing lineup, we are also honored to be giving away several digital copies of our Cosplay Academy instructor Down in Creative Studios' recent book, Cosplayer's Ultimate Guide to EVA Foam.
Nice. Oh, this one is very exciting. Janome Sewing Machines, they will be furnishing each of our runner-ups with a Janome Artistic Edge 12. And the winner of the Janome Sewing Award for Best Sewing will drag away an incredible Janome Skyline 9 sewing and embroidery machine.
Yeah.
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 Nice.
It doesn't end there, so let that be an incentive for joining next year, all right? But finally, we have an award for best prop presented by Hoku Props in addition to the absolutely stunning custom medallions he has created for each of our international prize winners. They are awesome.
I just caught, like, on the big screen what I look like, and I am so sorry for all of you. This is like in the Olympics, where you always want the one guy that's, like, just a normal runner. Like, that's me, but for cosplay.
You're perfect. You're perfect.
We have, right? we have a gold medalist.
Yeah. Oh. Well, and by comparison, let's bring up some people now that are absolute experts in the field, our judges.
Yes, judges!
They have the unenviable task of choosing our winners from among the plethora of talented individuals competing today.
Yeah, and in fact, they have been judging since Thursday. They already spoke to all of the competitors, and they are now very excited to see them on stage. So, let's bring out our first judge from Australia by way of Japan, Kay Cosplay!
you.
Also from Australia, and actually having arrived from the furthest point away in Australia, Kiralee Cosplay.
And next, from everyone's favorite Scandinavian nation, Sweden, please welcome Mayo Cosplay.
Arriving from the non-French side of Belgium, Mistvain.
Representing the windy city of Chicago, Papa Bear.
And somehow managing, even though she isn't a mile above sea level, please welcome from Colorado, Tekka.
Keep that up. One more big round of applause to all of our judges and the hard work before them.
You now, guys can go have a seat.
Yes, yes, please. Good luck.
Feel free to judge my daughter as much as you want.
No, hey.
Oh, so sorry.
Oh, they're doing a good enough job judging me.
Does not require any judging.
You're right.
We should just spoil.
Judge her.
Now, a little background on what you can expect from tonight's events. Our show today is broken into four segments: solo walk-ons and duo walk-ons, who are competing for the Cosplay International Foreign Exchange.
Our solo performers and our duo performers will be competing for the Nordic Cosplay Championship, the GCOF, and some will also be competing for the Cosplay International Foreign Exchange.
The Cosplay International Foreign Exchange is judged 100% on craftsmanship, so it's totally okay if they insult the judges. It's not held against them.
No, it's not. Do not insult the judges, ever. I'm a judge.
That's fair. That's totally fair.
Okay, all right. So, the Nordic Cosplay Championship is a 50% craftsmanship, 50% performance competition. And no one will be insulting the judges.
And the GCOF is judged at 30% craftsmanship and 70% performance, so insulting the judges would be pretty detrimental, but not an absolute game changer, especially if they all decide to do it together. Hint, y'all.
What are you trying to do?
Whatever
do
I want.
Do not give them
that's
bad.
You're
waka waka.
You're back on the adoption.
That's her catchphrase,
gosh.
Right? Waka waka, that's what I said. Waka waka, that's what I said.
Yeah, I'm not hearing.
Like the Pac-Man noise.
All right, audience.
They're so mad at me.
Okay, all right, time out. Are you ready for us to get the show started? Oh my God. Let us commence the Winter Cosplay Championship.
You're gonna go back up for adoption, I think.
Up first, entry number one in our solo walk-on competition.
We don't say who they are until afterwards.
Make sure you intro with cosplay names.
Yes. Yeah.
That was entry number one, hot cosplay as Nyx from Hades, the video game.
All right, entry number two, costhetic as Rhaenyra Targaryen from House of the Dragon.
I guess we're never supposed to be.
Well, that's counterintuitive to what everybody else does.
thank you so much, Costetic. That was Rhaenyra Targaryen from House of the Dragon. All right.
We're gonna stand over here, yes. So sorry.
A lot going on.
Up next, we have entry number 3 in our solo walk-on contest. Please give it up for Adam Red Creations as the Doomslayer from Doom.
He's looking for his bunny.
And next, entry number 4 in the solo competition is Trash Panda Cosplay as Lily of the Valley from Zakiso Original Art. Lovely. Give it up for Trash Panda Cosplay.
Now coming to the stage, entry 4 in the solo walk-on contest. Give it up for, you're right, that is number 5. That's what comes after 4.
Okay,
I'm learning, I just started school.
Mommy is here, it's all right.
Yeah, it's really different when you say mommy and not mama. Not gonna
mommy.
Lie.
Mommy, call me mommy.
All right, let's move it on. Move it on.
Move it on.
Leave my beautiful wife out of this.
We've got Blade Master Hunter Victor as Hunter from the Monster Hunter series.
Oh, he's pointing right at us.
Wow. Those moves.
Stage might not be big enough.
Very impressive. There we go.
Thank you so much, Blade Master Hunter Victor. Now, entry number 6 is Heather and Harmony, coming up as Three Homes Edelgard from Fire Emblem. Yas, Queen!
It sounds like most of you have selected the correct house in this game. Good job.
Blue Lions!
Phenomenal detail.
Thank you so much, Heather and Harmony.
Next, we have entry 7. Sown by Sharks as Fire Lord Azula by Sunset Dragon from Avatar, The Last Airbender.
Oh.
Don't say slay, she'll take that literally.
She will burn you. Thank you so much, Sown by Sharks. We have entry number 8 in the solo competition, walk on. Yuji Kong as Xiao from Genshin Impact.
Thank you, Unji Kong. Up next, we have entry number 9, Lothalina as Adam, Ayanosuke Shindo from Skate the Infinity.
Ah, she brought me a rose.
Yes,
I'll take the rose. That's, I accept.
Lovely. Thank you so much, Lothalina. So, entry number 10 is coming up next. Give it up for Shiver Fire as Tinkerbell from Peter Pan.
Very nice.
Clapping gives her life, literally.
That's right.
Good job, guys.
Clap, 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 clap.
Up next, entry 11, also in the solo walk-on contest, please welcome Kenpai Cosplay as Star Guardian Akali from League of Legends.
Nope. very practical weapons.
Lovely. Thank you, Kenpai Cosplay. We're now welcoming contestant number 12 on stage, Kay Stroob's Cosplay as Christmas-themed Belle from Beauty and the Beast.
Why can't you dress like that?
Oh! All right, now coming to the stage, we have entry 13 in the solo walk-on contest. Give it up for Sailor Moon Turtle as Sailor Moon from Sailor Moon, the musical Petit Étranger.
They've got the moves.
Yes.
They've got the moves.
Thank you, Sailor Moon Turtle. Our entry number 14, make lots of noise for Mackenzie Shane as Oogie Boogie from The Nightmare Before Christmas.
Oh.
Oh.
It was almost Snake Eyes.
I mean, you rolled a 7, so if you're playing craps, great job.
Transforming dress. Transforming dress. Happening. Happening right now. Oh, love it.
Very impressive. Was not expecting that.
Help. Yes. Yes. Go. Help. Husband. Okay.
It's the nicest thing you've done all night. Now we've got entry number 15 in the solo walk-on contest. Please welcome Seems Come True as Chihiro, designed by Hannah Alexander from Spirited Away.
So beautiful. And our entry number 16 is Aisha, coming on as La Senora from Genshin Impact. Gorgeous, gorgeous, thank you.
A lot of people screaming a lot of things at once, completely intelligible.
You're supposed to be able to hear all of that.
It's so awful in here.
Okay, all right, it's okay. I'll give you some peanuts later. Be a good girl.
I'm allergic.
Now we have entry number 17, Astral Pioneer as Muzan Kibutsuji from Demon Slayer.
Oh my! Wow.
There's a lot of mouths.
Final for Muzan. And we also have entry number 18 in our solo walk-on, Evilly Wicked Cosplay as Zagreus from Hades the Video Game. Thank you, Zagreus.
Next, entry 19, Mary Grimwario as the doll from Bloodborne.
They could not be here today, unfortunately, so we wish the queen all the best.
Just a round of a beautiful round of applause for them.
But next we have entry 21, Avira Cosplay as Valkyrie Vilifion, designed by Gladzy K from Pokemon.
Thank you very much.
Our well, up next, we have performances. So we are going to move off of the stage and begin.
I take up too much room anyway, sorry.
Now we have.
And now we have entry 22 in our solo performance. Please give it up for Sarah Spaceman. For Sarah Spaceman as 15th anniversary Miku X Strawberry from Vocaloid. Coming up next to the stage, give it up for entry 23 in our solo performance competition, Skull Weapon Works as Arthas Lich King from the World of Warcraft.
My son, the day you were born, the very forests of Lordaeron whispered the name. Arthas. My child, I watched with pride as you grew into a weapon of righteousness. Remember, our line has always ruled with wisdom and strength, and I know you will show restraint when exercising your great power.
Accept my gift.
Wow, give it up for Skull Weapon Works as Arthas, Lich King from World of Warcraft. All right, our next entry coming on in the solo performance category is Fashion Fantasy Sierra as Crystal from Carol and Tuesday.
Hey Martians, this next song's called Unbreakable. If you know the words, sing along. Never knew I was waiting right around the corner. Wasn't ready for you, cause I didn't wanna fall so hard. But you were there like the air when I felt like I was underwater. You're what I need, cause now I can breathe. You put the beat in my heart. Two hearts for broken pieces, that's who we were before. Somehow we fit together, now we're unbreakable.
Next, we have entry 25 in our solo performance competition. Give it up for Closet Chloe as Eliyase, the cyber version from Love Live! School Idol Festival.
Time we touch, I get this feeling, and every time we kiss, I swear I can fly. Can't you
for Closet Chloe as Ellie Ayase from Love Live! School Idol Festival.
Our next entry is entry number 26 in the solo performance category. It's Miu Usagi as Snow Miku, 2017 version, from Vocaloid.
Sorry. Okay, I'm here. Guys? Hello? Anybody? Huh, it's a new text from Sony. LOL, sorry. Concert is canceled. Budget cuts. Budget cuts? What do you mean? Oh, my phone, it's ringing. Maybe it's Sony. Oh, it's Scarlett. Not again. It was one time, Scarlett. The shampoo commercial was one time. You've got to be kidding me. Again?
Hi, Miku. This is Scarlett.
Hey, Scarlett. I know you're a Vocaloid fan, but can you turn down the mute? Okay. Bye. Think, Miku, think. What do people like nowadays? What are they doing in their free time? Maybe YouTube? Streaming? Yes, streaming! VTubers are popular. I wanted to thank you guys so much for coming to my first ever live stream. It really does mean a lot to me. Thank you so much, chat. Well, until next time, I'll talk to you later. Bye! Wow, 10 days streaming in a row? That's a new record! I can't wait to keep streaming with you guys. We've built up a community in such a short time, and it really does mean a lot to me. Thank you guys so much for being here. Until next time, bye! And for today's game, I thought it would be a fun idea to have chat pick the game. What do you guys think? Oh, hold on, 1 second, my phone's ringing. You've got to be kidding me.
Aww, very nice. Thank you so much. That was entry number 26, Miu Usagi as Snow Miku from Vocaloid.
Up next, put your hands together for entry number 27 in our solo performance contest. Give it up for Paladin Mabel as Raiden Shogun from Genshin Impact.
You are that which is furthest from eternity. Exceptional. Evasion is futile. Strike dead! Inferior. Lightning falls on the land of eternity. The lightning directly. Commendable. instabilities will be removed. Strike dead! Inazuma shines eternal!
That's right, let's hear it for entry 27, Paladin Mabel as Raiden Shogun from Genshin Impact.
Next is entry number 28 in the solo performance competition, Lady Iselina as Cardcaptor Sakura, Ice Angel Form from Cardcaptor Sakura.
There will be times when it all just falls apart, and you can't find your way through the day. Like the sea, you will fall and rise again. Just remember what I have to say. In the darkest night, you will find your light. You will overcome, 'cause you are strong enough. You're not one for giving up. You will rise above and find your light. Find your light in the darkest night. If that voice inside your head says you can't win, and it feels like you're just not good enough, never forget, you've got everything it takes. We might fall, but we always stand back up. 'Cause in the darkest night, you will find your light. You will overcome, 'cause you are strong enough. You're not one for giving up. You will rise above and find your light. Find your light in the darkest night. Find your light, find your light in the darkest night.
Give it up for Lady Iselina as Cardcaptor Sakura, the Ice Angel.
Up next on stage, we have entry number 29. Give it up for MK Cosplay Nerd as Sophie Hatter from Howl's Moving Castle.
What a dump! When I think castles, this is not what I picture. Well, a nice thing about getting old is nothing frightens you.
I don't envy you, lady. That is one bad curse. Curses are tough. You're going to have a very hard time getting rid of that one.
The fire spoke!
Let me guess. The curse won't let you talk about it, right?
Are you a howl?
No, I'm an extremely powerful fire demon named Calcifer! I just like to do that once in a while.
A fire demon? Well, then you should be able to break my curse.
Maybe, maybe not. Listen, if you can find a way to break the spell that's on me, then I'll break the spell that's on you. You got it?
All right. It's a deal.
Hey, lady, wake up.
Good morning. Time for breakfast.
I'm not taking any orders from you.
Oh, there's my hat. All right, Calcifer, let's get cooking.
I don't cook! I'm a scary and powerful fire demon. Blah, 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 blah.
How would you like a bucket of cold water in your face? Or maybe I should tell Hal about our bargain?
Oh, stupid me. I never should have let her in here.
So, what will it be? That's right. That's a good fire.
Here's another curse. May all your bacon burn.
All right. Now it's time to clean up this dump.
Sophie, please help me. I'm going out. Please give me some firewood, quick. Quick, come on. Please help me. Hey, what are you doing? No, don't. I'll fall. You crazy lady with tongs.
You'll be fine.
I'll fall. Help.
I'm just sweeping out the ashes.
No, I'm not fine. Help. Help. I'm falling.
See, you're fine.
Crazy old lady.
Incredible. Calcifer. Calcifer. Are you the one moving the castle?
Of course I am. No one else does any work around here.
I'm thoroughly impressed. You're a first-class fire demon. I like your spark.
She likes my spark.
All right, that was entry number 29. MK Cosplay Nerd as Sophie Hatter from Howl's Moving Castle.
And now let's welcome entry number 30 in the solo performance competition, Alpaca Ash as Ronnie the Witch from Elden Ring.
I'm the witch, Ronnie. I stole death long ago, and search now for the dark path, that I might one day append the whole of it, and rid the world of all that came before. So, it was thee who had become my lord. I am pleased, however. Thou art a fitting choice. Thou hast freed me. For that, you have mine thanks. I go now to the night sky. It is there I shall find mine order. I bid thee travel the path of the Lord, and once all is done, we shall see each other once more. Is over, I see. Thou hast done well. Now, I shall begin that which I dearly wish to accomplish. Too long has this world been held captive. Those within unable to make their own destiny. I do solemnly swear to every living being and every living soul. Now cometh the age of the stars. A 1,000-year voyage under the wisdom of the moon. Here beginneth the chill night that encompasses all, reaching the great beyond. Into fear, doubt, and loneliness, as the path stretcheth into darkness. Let us go together, my dear consort eternal.
That was entry number 30, Alpaca Ash as Rani the Witch from Elden Ring.
All right, for the next one, we are going to come out because we are back on some walk-on duos. All right, let's see. All right, this microphone's on, so we don't need this for the moment. All right, so up first, we have contestant 31, Salty Sisters Cosplay, Scaramouche and Foul Legacy from Genshin Impact.
Genshin Impact, their entry number 31. And coming up on stage next, entry number 32, Team Chiefly Creates and Neo Naka Cosplay as Seething Basic Use Armor and Kamura Village Hub Maiden from Monster Hunter Rise.
All right. That was entry number 32, Team Chiefy Creates, Leo Naka Cosplay as Seething Basil Goose Armor and Kamura Village Hub Maiden from Monster Hunter Rise. Now, contestant 33, Itty Bitty Blue, Anna and Elsa, Olaf's Frozen Adventure.
Entry number 33, Itty Bitty Blue as Anna and Elsa from Olaf's Frozen Adventure. We have another duo walk-on for you. Entry number 34, let's welcome Sammy is Weird as Diancy and Carbink from Pokemon. Wow, fancy Pokemon!
Oh.
Ooh.
I catch you.
Good job.
Thank you. That was walk-on contestant 34, Sammy is Weird, Diancy and Carbink from Pokemon. Up next, we have contestant 35, Moochie Bunny Studios, Fire Lords Azula and Zuko from Avatar, The Last Airbender.
Moochie Bunny Studios! Their entry number 35. They were cosplaying Fire Lord Azula and Zuko from Avatar The Last Airbender. So now we're gonna step off stage because it is time for some more performances.
Up first, we have entry 36 in our duo performance category. Give it up for Double J Cosplay as Lucy and Rebecca from Cyberpunk Edgerunners.
Kiwi, hey.
Hey, got an updated Militech training sim. David says he wants everyone in the crew to run it when they get the chance.
David did?
Yeah, just sent it.
Got it. Later.
Let's begin with basic combat training. I will train you to be proficient with firearms.
Yeah, yeah, target practice, got it.
Okay, Little Miss Perfect. Not bad.
Becca, what are you doing here?
I had Kiwi make some upgrades. There's no better drill sergeant than yours truly. Let's see how you handle a moving target. hacking? No fair. Better than I thought. Guess I'll have to let the real me know to watch her back.
Hey, David. We need to talk about Becca. Are you free tonight?
Welcome to the world of you. Your avatar is automatically generated using body sharing technology. You may not be able to start over in the real world, but you can start over in the world of you.
I can finally sing again?
It's time to live another you. It's time to start another life.
We didn't waste our time here. It's now or never.
What is this? What is this?
Hello? Is anyone there?
Stay back. Leave me alone.
You don't have to hide. Let me help you.
Lend me your voice. Words you try so hard to forget. Break through the silence.
covered in bruises.
I just need to endure this.
But who are you?
Belle, I can't tell you the truth.
The Beast is in trouble. I have to find his identity. But to gain his trust, I need to reveal who I really am.
I'm not crying, you're all crying. That was entry 36, double J, or no, it wasn't. That was K Cosplay and Sailor Pewter Fox as Belle and Suzu from Belle. Entry 37. We're going to give them a moment to de-beast the stage. Edward. Coming up next to the stage, we have entry 38, Restar as Tatsumi Kazehaya, Blessing Black, and Mayoi Ayase, Sacred Dusk, from Ensemble Stars.
entry number 38, Restar as Tatsumi Kazehaya, Blessing Black, and Mayoi Ayase, Sacred Dust from Ensemble Stars. Next is our entry number 39 in the duo performance. Let's welcome Craft and Furious as Lelouch V. Britannia and Euphemia Lee Britannia from Code Geass.
Hello?
Hey, what's up?
I need your help. Can you come here?
I can't. I'm buying clothes.
All right, well, hurry up and come over here.
I can't find them.
What do you mean you can't find them?
I can't find them. There's only soup.
What do you mean there's only soup?
It means there's only soup.
Well, then get out of this soup aisle!
All right, you don't have to shout at me! There's more soup!
What do you mean there's more soup?
There's just more soup!
Go into the next aisle!
There's still soup!
Where are you right now?
I'm at soup!
What do you mean you're at soup?
I mean I'm at soup!
What store are you in?
I'm at the soup store!
Why are you buying clothes at the soup store?
Oh no, that was entry number 39, Craft and Furious as Lelouch V. Britannia and Euphemia Lee Britannia from Code Geass. Why? Now we've got entry 40 in the duo performance category, The Stitch Witches as Anna and Elsa from The Stitch Witches.
You can't do this alone.
I have to. It's too dangerous for you.
Elsa!
I hear you. I'm coming.
What have you done? Show yourself. I'm dying to meet you.
Come, my darling, homeward bound.
I am found. I'm ready to learn.
What? The dam. It was a trick. It needs to be destroyed. It needs... No. Anna, I need you. Flurries? Olaf? Elsa? No! Elsa! The dam. Dam. Arendelle. Hey! Earth Giant! Over here! Break the dam!
Anna. Elsa. We did it. Together.
Give it up for entry number 40, the Stitch Witches, as Anna and Elsa from Frozen 2. Now let's welcome entry number 41 in the duo performance category. Royal Fire Cosplay as Janice and Julie from season 3 of Prepara.
Way more adorable than most of you deserve. That was entry 41, Royal Fire Cosplay as Janice and Julie from season 3 of Prepara. And up next, we have entry 42 in the duo performance category. Please welcome Gilded Feather Cosplay as Sakura and Sayoran Creamsicle Art Book Designs from Cardcaptor Sakura.
Sayoran, look what Tomoyo made me!
Matsuri, you look very beautiful.
Really?
Of course. May I have this dance, my lady?
Yes, I would very much like that. You know, this reminds me of the masquerade play that we did when we were younger.
Do I dare to ask which one?
You're a rather beautiful princess. But you do look very handsome as a prince, too.
I wanted to say, when I first came to Japan, my head was so filled with fulfilling my mission and catching the cloud cards. I didn't care who got in my way, but you always cared about the people around you and it showed. I did nothing but get in your way.
That's not true! You helped me so much when we were catching the cards! You're the reason I was finally able to transform them into Sakura cards!
Regardless, because of that, it's just one of the many reasons that you're the one, the person that I love the most.
I am?
You will always have my heart and be my princess.
Oh, Chiron, you're the one I love the most, too.
Ah, for entry number 42, Gilded Feather Cosplay. They were beautiful as Sakura and Chiron Creamsicle art book designs from Cardcaptor Sakura. And next up, we have some setup. This is going to be very exciting, guys. Let's welcome entry number 43 in the duo performance category, C4, Chris and Chris Cosplay Connection as Karl Ruprecht Kronen and Hellboy from Hellboy.
I don't understand what the big deal is with this BL stuff. I'm kind of into this Omegaverse. I mean, if anything, I'd be an Alpha. Yeah. Ooh, wonder if that's my Uber Eats. Oh, great. My mute adversary. What brings you back? Again? What a surprise. Wait, you get Spotify on that? I can't wreck you to this music. Change it! Yeah, that's much better. And hey, didn't they ever tell you not to bring a knife to a gunfight? I keep forgetting that. You know what? I've had it with all these fights. What do you want?
Is that all? Come here, I'll show you. I want you to show. I let my guard down, and then you pulled the rug.
I was getting kinda used to being someone you loved. I don't love you. Whatever gave you that idea?
Search your feelings, you know it to be true.
You know why I can't be with you. I'm not a bad guy.
If you are a bad guy, but this does not mean you're a bad guy.
Why would you want to be with me anyway? You know I've got baggage.
Love your curves and all your edges, all your perfect imperfections. Give
your... You really think this could work? Whoa there, Romeo. Slow down. Let's start with a drink and see where it goes from there.
Let's get excited. Oh, we just can't hide it. No, no, no. I'm about to lose control and I think I like it.
My! That was a new ship! A new ship is born! Give it up for... entry number 43, C for Chris and Chris Cosplay Connections as Karl Ruprecht Kronen and Hellboy from Hellboy. We are on to our last entry, so lots and lots of energy. Let's welcome them. They have worked so hard on their performances and their costumes. Look at that. All right, round of applause. applause for entry number 44, Wigwig Cosplay as Kamura Hunter and Yomogi from Monster Hunter Rise.
This is just too tough. I don't think I'll ever beat that monster.
Are you ready to order?
I suppose.
That's enough of that. You need something to psych you up. What about trying a different weapon?
I already tried everything. I even played bagpipes at them.
Fine. How about a theme song?
People still have those?
Of course they do. Come on, give it a shot. Try using your very favorite song.
I wanna be the very best, like no one ever was.
Whoa. Stop that. That song is off limits. We could get in trouble with Nintendo-sama. Look, I'll help you out. Why don't you just order the special?
Okay, sure. One special, please.
My good hunter, it is with the deepest pride and the greatest pleasure that we welcome you today. And now, we invite you to relax. Let us pull up a stool as the Dongo Stand proudly presents the special. Be our guest, be our guest. Put our Dongo to the test. They'll lift your spirits, make you buff, and you can do the rest.
Anjanath Rathalos, one hit and I'll be toast.
Try our Dongo, it's delicious. Don't eat mushrooms, they're suspicious. You can fight, you can win.
I'll cut them up and wear their skin. Make a helmet or a really fancy vest. The only question, do I use one sword or two?
You're the best, the best.
I'm the best. Rapian, Basil Goose, or whatever's on the loose.
We'll prepare and serve with flair our fluffy Dongo with some juice.
I'd like to lift a glass to giving me a pass to be the best.
Be your best.
Be my best, oh, be the best.
So how are you feeling now?
Ready to hunt some monsters.
Works every time.
All right, that was entry 44, Wigwig Cosplay as Kamura Hunter and Yomogi from Monster Hunter Rise. I'm not sure why they didn't think Disney would be more litigious than Nintendo, but we'll see what happens. All right, you ready?
Yes. Well, those were all of our contestants. What did you think? Did you enjoy the show? Give it up for all of our contestants. They have been planning this for months. They have shown you their creativity and their passion.
That is correct.
That's right.
Right amount of enthusiasm.
These judges appreciate them.
Yes.
And in fact, now it's time to dismiss our judges to go with the very, very hard job of picking our winners,
yes,
runner-ups, sponsor award winners, and they also have to pick their judges award. So good luck.
We're going to send them away to an airtight chamber. But don't worry, we've got something planned for you.
You mean like soundproof, right? Not airtight?
Oh God, I have to tell someone.
Good luck. So that falls to us now to provide you all with a little bit more entertainment while the judges are away. So.
Oh gosh.
I say that, but a lot of that responsibility is actually gonna fall back onto a few of you.
A few.
At least three.
That's right. For our halftime show, Jim, Zach, and I will be hosting some great improv games. But to do that, we need three volunteers from the audience to help us. So we will each be choosing a volunteer among you to come up and let's have some fun.
I'm gonna choose one.
All right. No one that's looking at making eye contact with me is raising their hand.
Have you
done kind of a problem
before?
We're looking for some people
Jurassic
who have
Park.
Good
on,
improv
go.
Experience, have gone and done this before.
Jurassic World. Yes.
So you don't know any games?
Jim, you shouldn't have to talk someone into it.
No, they're trying to talk me into letting them.
Use your Twilight-like spy charm. Come on.
Yeah. Ooh, Twilight. Are you Team Jacob or Team Edward?
I chose my one.
Ooh, you chose a waifu. Wait, are we gonna have to fight?
No, your best waifu.
All right, two. Two, and we need a third. Yeah, you right there, yeah. There are stairs over here. Please don't jump up the front.
Hey, welcome, welcome.
All right.
You know what? I gotta take the skirt off, because we're gonna be moving. So.
Hey. I probably shouldn't do that.
Hey, none of that. None of that. I'm watching you.
All right. So for the first game, we're going to keep things holiday inspired, and we're going to play a game called One Word at a Time. You may know it as, in this case, Six-Headed Monster. I'm going to start down on this end.
And just as a quick reminder for the microphones, make sure that you put them right in front
of
your mouth.
Right up to the mouth, yeah.
Yep, or else right up to there, like your coffin, all right? Nothing else, don't think of anything
else. I hate that pantomime so much.
Your coffin. That's how you hold the microphone.
Good.
Too far away, they can't hear you, and then you're not funny, and that's no good.
So the way that this game works is we're going to tell a holiday story one word at a time, and it's going to start with me. I'm going to say one word. It's going to move on to our next friend, who is going to say one word. It is then going to move to Yaya, who is going to say one word. It is then going to go to our next friend, who will say...
Wow.
Whoever said two words...
out. You're out. I'm sorry.
There's the door. Thank you for coming. Our next contestant will then say...
Three words.
Hey.
One word.
And then finally, Jim will then say...
Nine words? I'm going towards the front.
Yeah. Oh my God. And then it comes back to me, who will then continue with one word. And we'll hopefully present you all with a brand new, emotional, heart-wrenching holiday story. Are you guys ready? Yeah. 'Twas
the
night
before
Halloween.
And
my
mother's
butt. Sorry.
Hot.
Dirty.
And
she
traveled
far
to
China.
And
gather
all
mystical
creatures?
Like.
And.
Hey! Cheating!
Santa!
Blue.
Over.
My.
Dad.
And.
Hey! I'm about to come over there.
Presented
his.
All right, I like that.
I can't. I'm
We've
sorry.
Got to find out how this story ends.
Love.
Oh. And.
Friendship.
Oh. We're so wholesome.
And chip.
Okay, that's the end, I guess.
Oh my God.
So that was really just kind of to get things rolling. We want to take a moment now and actually meet our new friends. Please tell us who you are, where you're from.
I'm Jason Todd as Red Hood. My name is Nakora, and I'm from Bermuda.
Bermuda, awesome.
Bermuda.
Hi, I'm Idle Guts with a Z at the end. I am from Indiana.
Now,
welcome.
Just as a question,
no
do you have
cheers
any friends?
From Indiana.
No,
no.
Your
I
friends
have no
don't
lot
seem.
Of friends. Look.
No friends.
They seem zero excited, zero excitement.
No. Oh, what a betrayal!
Just kidding. I love them. They're all over there.
Where are they? I could not hear them.
I don't know, maybe in the back, actually.
I am bad girls, well, the third word I can't say, but it starts with a B, and it means a female dog. And the last word is blog, and I am from New Orleans, Louisiana.
All right, so for our next game, we're actually gonna dismiss Jim from the stage for the moment. He's going to go into a soundproof chamber.
Yes.
Airproof.
And we're gonna play a game called Party Quirks. So what this means is that our four party guests here need some quirks from you, the audience, that Jim is going to have to guess as they enter the holiday party. Are you all familiar with the game? All right, audience, we need some quirks for our friend here. We got it in one. You have severe bouts of narcolepsy. Yes, that is absolutely what it means. All right. How about for Yaya? Can we get hands? Hands help. Yes. IBS? I love it. I'm gonna take a couple more, and if nobody can beat IBS. What?
Be nice to me, remember all I've done.
They love body pillows? Okay. I'm not repeating that. Really loves arson. I'm a fan. Okay, you love it. How about for our friend here? Yes, you. They think they're a cat. Okay, let's add, who can add to that? No, actually, perfect. You are a cat with IBS. I'm sorry, contestants, this is not about you. It's about them. And finally, right here, I saw this hand. Maybe. You are afraid of the color red. And that's going to be a problem. All right, so if I can have you all back over onto this side of the stage, I'll go try and find Jim. Somebody find me Jim. Jim.
It's airtight.
Were you just sitting in a Tupperware container?
Yes. It helps preserve me.
Oh, God. Are you ready for your amazing holiday party? I'll give you a moment to tidy up and get
ready.
Yes,
I just gotta make sure I've got all of my, okay, I've got everything set up. I'm gonna put this here. All right, I've got chips out. I've got some drinks, some arsenic. Oh, no, not that. Just regular drinks. Okay, flop up the couch. All right, my neighbors are doing something in the backyard. All right, put on some TV. Okay, all right, guests should be arriving any minute. Oh, okay. Hey, come on in.
Hello, how are you doing?
Good.
Just a question, is there a random couch and or bed anywhere in the place?
Yes, I've got a couch right here. Perfect. And I've got some chips and some drinks, there's TVs on. We're playing the game. All right, enjoy yourself. Gotcha.
Thank you very much.
All right. Oh, yes, my next guest. Come on in. Hi, how you been? It's been so long since it was college, since we last saw each other. How have you been?
Meow.
What the? It's new carpet. What are you doing?
Meow.
Oh my gosh. Hi. Oh, how have you been?
I'm okay. I'm a little cold. Do you have like a fire going somewhere?
I do. It's a TV show though.
No. So you don't have like a, you know, something that I could.
I've got a blanket. Do you want a blanket?
I can make it work. So.
Hey.
My
new tie.
The tie's gotta go.
The tie?
The tie is, yes. Stay back. What? Just please change your tie. Just, can use your other hand to cover it better.
Fantastic.
Mm-hmm. Use both hands to cover it. Yeah, almost. A little higher. A little higher. Okay, we're cool.
Hey, how's it going? Did you find that blanket?
Yeah, hold on. You said the couch was right...
Right here.
Cool, thanks.
Yeah. Are you narcoleptic or...
Yay!
Seriously? Oh, all right.
Good job.
Okay. Those impressive moves. All right. We're catching up. It's so great. And
I'm trying to set you on fire.
You got into some weird stuff in college. You've changed a bit. You're not chasing your tail. Are you a furry with worms?
Close enough. Close enough, I think, right?
Meow.
All right. You are an animal with a cat with worms?
That's close enough, I think.
It is close enough. It really is, yeah.
What? No? They're saying no.
All right, keep it going then.
Was it close enough or no?
They need more.
Okay. All right. I've got some venomous over there.
Why are you still wearing that tie? And
I'm sorry.
You, the roses. The
What do you want? What do you want?
Back up. Hmm? Domrus Rex, I choose you.
Yeah? Oh!
Do you have something against ties? Like nooses, ties?
I cannot have it with that tie, nor those roses on her head. They both gotta go.
What's wrong with my roses?
Everything is wrong with those
roses, honey.
Everything is wrong with those roses.
They're so beautiful. I mean.
Yeah.
No, they're not. They're terrifying. Stop
following
me.
You're scared of, no, that's not a plant.
Hold on.
That's a tie.
Hold on, I got
All right,
you.
Those are plants. Oh my gosh. Wife. Wife, why are you, no, you're not my wife here. You're flashing him though. All right. You're scared of flashers? No, because it's the roses too. What about your hair? Have you checked out your hair?
My own hair?
Yeah, have you looked at it?
Well, why? What's wrong with it?
Well, I've got a mirror over here.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Oh my God!
All right. I think you're afraid of the color red.
Yeah! Woo!
I need to put away all of my sharp objects. Okay, I have absolutely no idea.
I know.
You've been a wonderful guest.
Give me a lighter.
A lighter?
I need a lighter.
Yeah.
I need matches.
You need, yeah. It's just a TV log. It's not a real fire.
Not good enough. Okay, take your suit off. We're gonna try to light it on fire.
It's nylon. It's non-flammable.
There you go. Yeah, I can make it work.
You can make it work.
I can make it work. Let's
okay.
Go.
You hate fashion?
That is such an insult. No matter who.
It is to my fashion. You want some fire?
Yes.
You're trying to start a fire?
Yes.
You
love fire.
You love fire.
Yes.
You're a fire lover, there's a word, arsonist.
Yay! Let's hear it for all of our amazing party guests.
Oh my gosh.
All right.
Wait, what? What was the furry?
The furry with worms?
Yeah.
Which might be the best thing I've ever heard uttered on stage. They were a cat, but they also had IBS.
Oh.
The classic trope.
Yes. I always hate that crossover episode of the anime episodes.
All right, so we have time for at least one more game, and this one is going to be a Hallmat exclusive. So I hope you're all ready for a brand new episode of Spy Family.
Oh, gosh. Oh, that one. Oh, God.
That has never aired before.
Oh, God. Okay.
So take that, Crunchyroll and or Hulu and or wherever it's actually streaming. What's going to happen is the three of us are going to be acting out a scene. However, this is the dub. And so our friends over here will be providing
my goodness.
The voices for the three characters. So providing the voice to Lloyd Forger. Your name again?
Cora.
Cora. That's me. As your forger, we've got...
Idle Guts.
And the person being punished the most, our friend...
Bad girl.
So, Mama, Papa, why don't you start us off?
Good morning. How are you doing today? Lovely day, isn't it? Hey, I noticed you're looking a little red there in the face, specifically on your head. What's going on?
My head? What?
Yeah, exactly, your head.
Oh, I just thought I'd try something new.
Oh, you tried something new? Ah, awesome. I like it. Okay. Yeah, you sure red is your color?
Yeah, I am. Aren't you going to ask me what it is?
Sure, why?
What? Wait, I need to be closer. Well, what?
Wouldn't you like to know?
Oh.
Yes, I would very much like to know.
It's something very special I whipped up just for you today.
Oh, you looked it up just for me. That's so swell. Thank you very much, Yor. What was your motivation behind this, exactly? What is your motivation behind this, exactly?
Our enemies.
Our enemies, is that correct?
Hey, Mama! Hey, Papa!
Speak of the devil! Hello there, little enemy.
Hello,
I'm
Peanut.
Your special baby! I'm so happy to be here!
That's great, honey. Oh my gosh. Why aren't you doing your math homework?
Don't you love my shirt? Look how professional
I love it. Don't interrupt. Your mother's about to tell me just exactly how she got the roses on her head.
I swear it's not screen printed.
Well, these roses were made specially for me with the blood of our enemies.
Ah, I like it even more now. It's great. And ever since I saw you just covered in blood the first time we met, I just instantly was drawn to you.
I figured it'd be the most romantic gift I could give you.
Yeah, ooh, maybe we should.
Do you want me to leave the room?
Please.
Yes. Now.
Go.
Okay.
You're grounded.
Count to 10 and you can stay. Oh, okay, cool. Very good. Just trying to fix the little straps I see in the back of your dress. You know, it's no problem, whatever. Just trying to check to make sure that there aren't any more roses.
Oh, thank you so much.
Awesome. Yeah, no roses to be accounted for anymore.
I'm going back.
Oh, I forgot to tell you something.
Why are you back?
Why?
It's very, very important.
Anya, count to 10 for me.
Are you ready?
Yes.
Okay,
yes.
Okay, yes. Here we go.
Okay.
Merry Christmas!
That's not even 10 letters. I don't... How well are you doing your homework? Please. Oh, we're done?
Sure.
Sure.
I don't know, just like...
Oh my goodness.
Now you all have to sing the ending theme. Go. I know, it was a joke. You don't have to do it.
Gotcha.
So now, let's turn things around a little bit. And why don't the three of you come on up to the front here? Because turnabout is fair play, friends. But as this is probably not an episode of Spy Family, it might be. I've seen half of maybe one episode. We need a scene for our friends here. Any?
Hottest men in anime!
As much as I love the prompt, hottest men in anime, this is a family event. I need hands, I'm sorry. Audio processing stuff. What? They're going to Disney World. That's a great start. How can we add to that? Yes, you right here. To play Magic the Gathering. Okay, why are they going to Disney to play Magic the Gathering? Yes. So they want to go to Disney to play Magic the Gathering with Jack Sparrow. You guys can figure out who's who.
Yeah, somebody has to be Jack Sparrow.
Oh, and we should probably say who's who. We're gonna just stay with our current partners, yes?
No,
okay.
I want the one that I picked.
Oh, okay.
Yes, I've got the voice. I think I can do a perfect voice for her.
Jim's got Indiana on lock, okay.
All right, I guess I will go with Bad Girl.
That's Red Hood, thank you very much. Hood.
Bad Girl.
Oh, Bad Girl, not Bat Girl. I will take Red Hood then. Okay, there we go. Let's line up so people can see. There we go. All right. All right, so they're on their way to Disney to play Magic the Gathering with Jack Sparrow.
Are they meeting Jack Sparrow there?
Yes, maybe. All right, we'll find out.
Which one of you is Jack Sparrow?
That's kind of how improv works, Yaya. We'll find out together.
Oh my God.
All right, we're gonna begin.
Hey guys, I'm really excited to head to Disney.
I know, I can't wait. I'm so excited to meet Jack Sparrow.
Well, little did you know, Jack Sparrow has been here all alone.
Oh my goodness, I'm your biggest fan. Can I have a photo?
What? You're Jack Sparrow? That's ridiculous.
I know that my Jack Sparrow voice is terrible, and that's why I work at Disney, because if anyone can say anything about Disney, it's that their performers are absolutely lackluster.
Well, I can at least tell that you're drunk and inebriated. That much is obvious.
Now, which one of you is going to duel me?
Well, we have the set of cards and we're hoping to duel you on the table.
Do you have a magical table? Something Disney related or thing? You know, where do I tap a land?
I don't know. God.
Nailed it, Jim.
Thanks.
I don't know.
Well, thankfully, as this is Disney, this is the world of magic. And look away, look to your right, right now. Look to the right. Now look back. There's a table!
Oh my gosh.
Pirate magic.
Where did you get that?
Pirate magic is also known as theft. And I found it.
Wait, is that from my grandma's house? Come on, Jack. All right, how do I banish you to the shadow zone?
Well, let's start things off by declaring and shuffling our decks. I am playing a mono black deck. I have a pirate theme, and I promise you that I'm using only type 2 standard cards.
All right, that's pretty easy. I'm doing third generation, full blast, exploding kitties.
And I have the special card, the one that trumps all and wins the game immediately. So there we go.
Hey, this is just a picture of a piece of paper.
Why do you have a picture of a piece of paper? You could have just brought a piece of paper.
Wait, this is on really nice estate stock. You went and you printed this?
Sorry.
Yeah!
I'm kind of really enjoying the awkward silence, I'm sorry.
I can't,
So, as much as I appreciate you bringing your entire deck and facing me, and you bringing your single card deck that is apparently tournament legal now, because that's how this game works, thanks Hasbro. What we're going to do is play a game of two-headed giant. That is where I, Jack Sparrow, Captain of the Black Pearl, will use my black deck to defeat both of you at once. I start by playing a card from the hand that I already drew when you weren't watching.
Oh.
Whoa, sleight of hand.
It's a giant card. It's still a swamp, though. It just does nothing, and now it's your turn.
All right, I guess I'll go next. I'm gonna play Exploding Kitten. Tap so, that. It's a mana attack card.
I'm
with Rush.
Okay.
I guess I want to play Raging T-Rex next.
Wait. I have a real big question. Did anyone else notice that they pulled that card out of the sheet of paper?
It's a magic sheet of paper.
Oh, they gathered the magic. I get it now.
Indeed, there.
I've got to ask. It looks like you two both put in a lot of effort to bring your interesting cards here to Disney to face me, Captain Jack Sparrow, Captain of the Black Pearl.
We heard that already.
I know, I have like two lines that I know from Jack Sparrow, so let me just do them, okay?
What happened to our matey?
You know what's really crazy? Is that we're playing this entire game on a roller coaster.
Whoa!
Oh my God, no!
Whoa, oh, it's going uphill. Wait, I'm falling out of my cage for some reason, and I'm back in.
No, I will save you.
Thank you. Oh, make a cool pose for the picture.
That's right.
Well, thank you both for coming, but I must inform you that you both lost before we ever started.
Yeah,
what?
My cards blew away because we were on a roller coaster. That was dumb, Jack.
And that's my winning strategy. Thanks for playing, everyone.
All right.
Well, I love being the only person on stage who knows anything about Magic the Gathering for an entirely Magic the Gathering themed skit.
Excuse me, I believe everything I said was Magic the Gathering tournament legal. Sorry.
Music. So we still need a little bit of time, huh? Two?
Where are the judges?
We need 2 minutes.
Oh my God.
And so we're gonna play a really quick game. How many of you are familiar with freeze tag? All right, freeze tag is very simple. We're going to start with two contestants. Jim, if you'd like to join me up here.
Hello, I'm a contestant.
You are, I guess, I don't know why I'm calling you contestants. None of you are winning anything, by the way.
They're winning love and admiration.
That's right.
All of which, it's...
They've won the hearts of Indiana. Although, to be fair, I've seen who you all voted for governor, so I'm not putting that bar very high.
Oh, you're getting the no.
I'm getting the no, and that's fine. So, I guess we are in Florida. That's going to miss. So, here's the deal. That joke was going to go one of two ways.
Yes. All right, we're limited. Let's do a quick round.
So the way this works is Jim and I are going to start a scene, and at any point in time, any one of these other people may say, freeze, at which point Jim and I must freeze in whatever we're doing. They will replace one of us, they will tag out, and start a brand new scene based on the frozen pose. Are you all ready? Yeah. All right.
Oh, gosh.
Papa, I've got some questions for you.
Yeah, I have a lot of questions for you. What, you shrunk my suit. I didn't even ask you to clean my, I mean, look it. You've shrunk it. It's absolutely shrunk.
Here's.
Look at what you have done to all this time I spent working on this thing for the last minute of home ed. What is wrong with you?
I'm so sorry. Hang on. This will buff out, I swear.
What is wrong with you? Come on. That is water soluble.
It's water soluble?
It broke it like 15 minutes ago, and I had to quickly run to the cosplay repair part, and unfortunately, it was out.
So, I want to be clear. You're wearing knee pads.
Yes.
That are water soluble.
Yes.
Which means they dissolve in water.
Yes.
And you were hanging out by the pool.
Yes.
That's not the pool, that's your knee.
Maybe.
Why?
Because I look good. And if I suffer in cosplay, everyone will give me attention.
Okay. I'm not 100% certain that works, but I don't think I can call myself a cosplay expert in my current attire.
I know you look pretty comfortable. It's like last day, so.
Yeah, you know what it is? It kind of moves around. It's very
nice. Yeah.
Woo. Freeze.
Thank God.
But check out my quick change.
Okay, 3, 2, 1, change.
It already happened before you started counting. Where'd my wig go,
though? Do it again. I don't know, I saw like a really big orange blur going that way.
Yeah, something dead on the floor over there.
Yeah, someone was screaming about red.
So.
Okay.
Do you want to hit up that panel?
The freeze. Panel?
Hey, I've lost my contacts. Is there any chance?
No.
I don't know where. Oh wait, I'm wearing glasses. I don't even have contacts.
Freeze. Now, we've been together for a really, really long time.
Oh, freeze!
And
freeze! What were you saying? Have you been a bad girl?
Freeze!
I think you have been a bad
freeze.
Girl.
Freeze! Freeze!
Freeze! You have to go in the same position.
Mrs. Your Forger, please I am looking for a new wife.
Woo! I'm all yours.
Yes!
Freeze! Woo! Freeze!
Well, thank you for coming.
Did you just say freeze again?
You're just all of that effort.
All right.
You can take it back.
No, no, go ahead. Go ahead.
Go ahead. Go. No, 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 no.
No, come on in. All right. Well, thank you for coming for Brad's Bargain Wives. And I'm so excited that you were able to scrounge together 1995. And you got me, the best wife of all time.
Can I get Tengen back?
There's no annulments. Oh, this is all final. By the way, I've got a lot of creaky joints, so we're gonna be like this for a long
time. Freeze.
Not you.
Oh, not me. You get to where she was. Wait.
Wherever you are, I believe. Hold me, hold me. This is my number. That my heart will go on. Lower, we just met.
I'm so sorry. Okay, here we go.
We'll stay forever this way. Okay, yeah, you're looking a little touchy there.
What?
Five.
Oh, yeah, sorry. I know the rules now. It's been a while.
Thank you very much.
Yeah. So, you know, this is crazy. I haven't seen you in 10 years. Look at you now.
Yeah, look at you now.
What a happenstance I run into you on the street like this.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. You know how things go here.
Wait a second. Yes. Are these water-soluble knee pads?
They absolutely are. I love that you noticed it.
And scene. Oh. Water-soluble knee pads. They're the future, y'all. Let's hear it for all three of our amazing guest contestants slash performers slash wig eaters. Thank you all so much for coming up on stage. And you can be seated and or track down your flying bird of a wig.
Thank you so much.
I got you these.
Oh, thank you. We have the winners. Oh my goodness. Wow.
These are words.
Well, that's right. You're four.
Well, this is the most exciting part of the night. Do you want to know who won? Do you want to know who's going to Japan?
All right.
Do you want to know who's going to Sweden and South Korea?
Is it me?
No.
I wish we could all.
Once again, though, real quick, a huge special thanks to our partner events. That would be the Cosplay Exchange with the World Cosplay Summit in Japan, the Nordic Cosplay Championship with Narcon Somar, Sweden, and GCOF with South Korea.
All right, and if we could have our judges back on stage for the Judges Award, Tekka Papa Bear Cosplay, Kara Lee Cosplay,
Mistvane.
We're going to bring them out in the order that they are ready.
Go ahead. Yes.
And Maya.
Welcome. Welcome. Come on up, judges. Come center and front.
We're going to move to the side. We're going to make some room for you.
First of all, what do you think? How do you feel? How do you feel?
We're absolutely exhausted. Each and every contestant was so good that we were fighting in the backstage just to decide who won.
Were you able to breathe in the airtight chamber? Really sorry about the mix-up.
No, apparently that's a no.
I believe we are going to present some awards, right?
We have the judges' awards.
Do you need the list or do you know who your winners
are? We have our own list. So
all right.
Who'd like to start us off?
Thank you. The judges' awards are obviously people who we chose for our own reasons. And so I'm going to lead off. This entry I thought had amazing stage presence. The construction also blew me away, flipping scenes, and was stunning. So my judges' award goes to entry number 7, Sewn by Sharks.
They're coming.
It's a big backstage, everybody. It takes time to get through it all.
Oh,
Congratulations.
All right, so I am up next, and I'm going to announce who they are, and then we're going to talk a little bit about them. So my award goes to number 40, the Stitch Witches, for Anna and Elsa, because I tell you, the embroidery on this was amazing. The paneling, the patterning, it was chef's kiss. So please give them a round of applause, guys, as they make their way on stage.
All right. My judges' award goes to none other than number 36, Double J Cosplay, to Lucy and Rebecca. Woo! Woo! Now, what I liked about their act was that they used the physical and the digital together. Once the Rebecca was thrown off, you saw all the dust and the blocks of cinder throwing around. That's stage acting, and that's what I absolutely love. So, ladies and gentlemen, give it up! Congratulations.
So, my judges' award goes to my lucky number, actually, number 24, Fashion Fantasy Sierra, who gave us a really dazzling performance. She utilized the screen well, she had multiple stage props, and also did her own singing, which I find very impressive. So, please give her a big applause.
My judge's award is next, and mine goes to number 39, Craft and Furious. Otherwise known as Soup. So, these lovely costumes actually were earmarked for me in their craftsmanship judging, but I was crying with laughter through your entire skit as soon as it started. So, you guys were amazing. Congratulations. Okay, you might notice I am not Papa Bear, but he had to leave, so I'm going to give his award. So Papa Bear's award goes to, where are we? Yes, number 43, C4, Chris and Chris Cosplay Connection.
I think we can all agree that Papa Cosplay definitely one of them to win. He loved it.
Papa Bear walked in, we literally sat down, and the first words out of his mouth is, "My judge's award is going to C4. Sorry if anyone else wanted them."
They're mine.
Congratulations, guys.
Come up to the front. Come up. Come up for a photograph. Photograph.
As that completes the judges' awards, we're now going to move on to our sponsor awards. Starting things off, the Arda Wig Award. Is that being presented by one of you?
Yeah. Yes. So the Arda Wig Award goes to entry number 11, Kenpai Cosplay. Now this wig really impressed us from the point of hand dyeing it from scratch to get the gradient and also the construction. It blew us all away, so congratulations.
Look at our wig, wonderful.
Thank you.
we have the Joy of Cosplay Award presented by Famore Cutlery. Come on up, Brent.
They want me to show it off.
We get a close-up on this, please, because wow. These are absolutely insane.
Fancy.
Can we get an ooh, ah.
Ooh, ah.
So great.
It is an absolute honor to be on this stage.
This is just too tough. I don't think I'll ever beat that monster.
Oh!
Really?
Oh,
are you?
Oh, are we doing this? Brent,
sorry,
we got
random monster. I believe in you. You can defeat this monster. You got this.
We will do this.
Yeah, there you go.
To be on this stage is absolutely amazing. And everybody, please give a big round of applause to the staff of Holiday Matsuri for putting this thing together. Without you, there is no us.
Yeah.
So thank you for doing what you do that allows us to do what we do. Big a round of applause to every one of these contestants that have put their heart and their soul into what they have done. And in appreciation for that, this is a completely hand-hammered, forged scissor. Takes 3 months to make one pair. Completely hand-etched, hand-ground, hand-polished, hand-edged, will provide a lifetime of cutting for generations to come. And for the efforts that you put into your work, we want you to appreciate the efforts and our work. So thank you and congratulations.
We haven't called them up.
We haven't called them up.
The winner yet.
Oh. We have to pick.
That would be handy.
And the winner is... Number 35, Mochi Bunny Studios.
These are amazing.
Excellent job. Now, for our next sponsor, Hoku Props Best Prop. Hey there, guy.
Hi, everyone. I don't know how to follow that up. That was inspirational, right? All right, so let's get through this. So, the You Caught My Eye Award goes to Unji Kong as Xiao. From Genshin Impact.
Oh, here you go. At least I have to give them the award and shake their hand. Oh, and then it's up to you.
All right. Now for our next award.
Next we have the Sherbonder Armor Award, which is going to be presented by HDC Fabrication.
Pleasure to be here, to be representing Sherbonder. It's a fantastic company. Be back at Holiday Matsuri, be back on the stage, so thank you. And it is my absolute honor to present the Sherbonder Armor Award to contestant number 5, Blade Master Hunter Victor.
A lot of that.
Tell them about it. Give them
a real quick speech.
Just say a real quick pitch.
Absolute beautiful work. I gotta actually take a look at this backstage. Monster Hunter is fantastic, one of my favorite games, but I have yet to make a set by myself. Exquisite paintwork, exquisite foam work, helmet work, everything is just beautifully done, exquisitely crafted, especially from a game that requires too much detail to pull this stuff off. So thank you so very much. And do we
have an actual package?
Yes, they get a full package.
One more round of applause.
All right.
All right. Next up, we have the Best Sewing Award. And this is a Janome Sewing Machine for the Janome Sewing Machine Award. Will one of our judges please announce?
So judges, come in here. We're going to read it together, all right? So the Janome Award goes to... This one, everyone? Oh. 38 Restar! Restar's costumes were absolutely beautiful. Amazing. Everything to the last stitch, to the last beading, to the last facet was just seamless, you could say.
For the moment they stepped on stage, let me tell you, dazzling.
This is what we meant by dragging home.
Yeah, good luck.
I hope you didn't fly.
Yay! Have fun!
All right, let's hear it for all of our recipients of our Judges Awards and our Sponsor Awards. Which means we are now moving on to the final awards. That's right, the International Awards. Are you ready?
Good. One guy is not ready. We're gonna have to wait for him.
Well, no, we're gonna move forward.
Oh yeah, sorry.
Shall I start?
Please.
We're going to announce the runner-up for the Cosplay Exchange. So they are going to Nagoya, Japan next year, or they're the runner-up for the Cosplay Exchange. So that's in case the winners cannot make the trip.
Right.
And the runner-up is number 15, Seems Come True.
Ooh.
Say something.
So this costume, literally we were in tears when we were in the judging room. The everything to the last beating. If you get a chance, please see this up close. There was a lot of love. There was a lot of passion. Hours and hours of effort that was put into this costume.
If you have a look at the embroidery on the bottom half of this dress, it is amazing. So many stitches, so many hours.
All right. And for the Cosplay Exchange 2023 winner, we have a special guest joining us on stage to announce it. No? No, we don't. That special guest, Miss Yaya Han.
Oh, hi.
Yay!
Okay. All right, so this winner will go to Nagoya, Japan in 2023.
Whether they want to or not.
That's right. Very, very excited for them to experience this. It's number 32. Team Chief Lee Creates and Leonaka Cosplay!
Oh my god, let me tell you how amazing these costumes were. Both in the fabric department and in the armor department stood out so well. And I think they will have an amazing experience in Japan.
So they will be coming to WCS, and as someone who has been to this competition and won it, I know these two will have such a wonderful experience and will be able to bring all of that back here home and hopefully one day share that with the community here, and who knows what will happen after that.
And ladies and gentlemen, here they are with their big armors and their big shields.
Woo!
It's a ticket only for two. The pig's gonna have to stay.
I'm sure he'll fit in carry-on.
All right. Now, for our next runner-up award for the G-Cough, number 44, Wigwig. Can you tell us something about this runner-up?
So this runner-up, their work was immaculate. It was gorgeous. And their skit was absolutely amazing. Absolutely fantastic. I think we can all agree. Round of applause, guys.
And to announce the G-Cough Awards, we will bring on Jua. Antonia, I apologize. Yes. It doesn't.
Hello. Yes. Yeah, from Korea. And then, yes. 37? Yes. Yes, 37. Kaya
Cosplay. Oh, yeah. Let me tell you, the moment they walked backstage with that big wolf, oh God, that was wonderful. The costumes as well, the quick changes, and especially during the act, we did not expect them to change back and forth.
So I was crying on the table when this happened. Their performance was moving, and we know that they moved everyone here, and they are going to do an amazing job when they go overseas to compete.
Hello, Hallmat! Hi! And hi, Aya! Now it's time for the Nordic Cosplay Championship winners.
Yes! We have to announce
you want to do the runner-up first?
I want to do the runner-up. I like being on stage. My name is Sam, and I'm the main organizer of NCC, and it's been such an amazing experience being here on Holiday Matsuri. You have such a good festival! I hope you had a really good time. It's going to be really, really exciting to see who will represent the US in the Nordic Cosplay Championship 2023. Do we have the results?
Yes. Runner-up.
Runner-up, yes. And I also have my own document, you know, up here.
Oh my.
Yeah, be prepared. So, we will start with the runner-up with the following motivation. A well-made costume and with great movement and present on stage. Can I get a drum roll, please? The runner-up for the Nordic Cosplay Championship 2023, Team US, is contestant number 30, Alpaca Ash. Welcome on stage. Woo!
Now, this costume, let me tell you, ridiculous with the hat, wonderful done. It's insane. I love to see some Elden Ring. We all love the performance.
My favorite part was how she gave away the entire ring.
You have to shake all the hands, every hand.
Every hand. Go up to the audience, and everyone, a big round of applause. Okay. The moment we've all been waiting for. Who will represent Team US in Sweden July next year on the Nordic Cosplay Championship 2023? With the following motivation. A very impressive and detailed costume and lots of high energy on stage. Drum roll, please. Team US. Your finalist is contestant number 22, Sarah Spaceman!
feet?
We did it.
My head hurts.
Your head hurts. What are you going to do tonight?
Well, I want to take this off so I can go to the bathroom.
Sounds good. A big round of applause.
Thank you so much.
All right, let's have one more huge round of applause for all of our winners.
All our winners.
All right, we're going to come in. Come in for a picture.
Which we need
a big picture with all of our winners.
Yes.
Let's get a big picture. All of our winners, all of our judges.
If you can stagger, if you can kneel, come in the front. We want to make like two or three different tiers.
Get in real close, like we just got over some big world pandemic.
Can you kneel? Can you sit? Anyone? So you got to scooch in, guys.
Come on in, sponsors.
We got to fill here up in the front. Anyone?
One of these things is not like the others.
Check out.